This is Fred Beck from Fred Talks Fighting, proudly sponsored by Empire Fight Store and joined by someone who he's probably seen most on this channel rather than his own channel. I'm joined by Slim. Slim, it's good to see you. Not soon after
Yo,
event. How are you?
that's I'm doing good, bro. That's so true, bro. I'm on your channel more than I am on my own channel nowadays, bro. Only because I love you, Fred. Only because I genuinely love you, man. Honestly, man. But I'm good, man. I'm back here in New York City. Crazy week in Texas, bro. Tell me not, Fred.
It was, yeah. We started off slow. And then by the Friday, things got a little mental.
Yo, man, it was insane, bro. I still get pictures of you like trying to break up the fight, bro. Like, no, don't.
Anthony,
It'll
Anthony,
happen.
Anthony.
Bro, you're crazy for that, bro. 135 pounder, 120 pounder, jumping in between two giant guys, bro. You could have got seriously hurt, bro. And that would have been very bad for the community, Fred, okay? That would have been very bad.
You just see the kid in the red jumper just drop like that. Middle of the hole, bro.
Oh my God. Yo, is red your favorite color, by the way?
Yeah.
Is your favorite color? Oh, nice.
Yes.
Nice. I could tell, man. I could definitely tell, Freddy boy.
You're switched on like that, Slim. You just tell like that. You know.
Hell yeah, man. Oh man, bro. Well, I can't get over Saturday night, bro. Saturday night was crazy. Saturday night was
How was it
insane.
commentating it?
Yo, commentating was so fun, bro. Like I had an amazing time commentating alongside Todd Grisham and Wade. Bro, it was fun, bro. But calling a fight as you see is not as easy as it looks, but I had an amazing time. I thought I did a pretty good job. Did you listen to my commentary,
I
Fred?
saw it. It was pretty good. I was impressed. I was impressed.
Yeah. Oh, he was impressed. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Generally, you're not just saying that because I'm here, right?
No,
You're
I
not saying
saw it. I
that.
was reading all the speech tweets too. I was liking the tweets on Twitter because of people saying, oh yeah, Slim's commentary. Wasn't that bad? It was good.
Hey, I like that. That's my first time. I can get better. I definitely can get better, but I love boxing. I love boxing. I love watching it and commentating it was just like the icing on the cake, bro. Being there ringside, seeing everything go down, it was crazy, bro. And then whenever something crazy happens, you see my reaction going, oh, like I always wanted that, bro. Like, you know what I mean? I always wanted to see that. It was fun, bro. It was so amazing to see.
Weren't you talking to the ring card girl as well?
Oh, how do you know? How do
Wait,
you know?
wait.
Wade told you.
Yeah.
Wade told me every time they were coming around, I was just waving. I'm like, hi. I was like, and Wade was like cracking up. I was like waving. I was like, wow. It was
Yeah,
so funny. What did you say to Wade?
I interviewed Wade after the fight. And I was asking about, oh yeah, what was it like to commentating with Slim? He was like, oh yeah, it's really good. It's complimenting you. The last thing he said was, oh yeah, he likes to talk to those ring card girls as well. I was like, that's Slim.
My man Wade. Yo, it was so cool, man, commentating with him. I was on Wade. I was like, yo, Wade, you got the best job in the world, bro. Like, this is the best. Like, if I'm not fighting, I just want to be a part of the event, you know, just hosting or commenting, doing something, bro. Because just being around that atmosphere is just different, bro. Tell me not, Fred. You
It
agree,
is
right?
fun. It is fun. But I like fight nights. I also find it quite stressful because if interviewing, it's like grabbing the person at the right time. And so say you're in a corridor and someone's walking past you grab, oh, can I grab you quick 5 minutes, mate? Or, it's never 5 minutes. It was like 2 minutes, 3 minutes. So it's position yourself in the right place at the right time. Where for like jobs like Wade, it's a lot. I guess you know what's going to happen. There's a structure to it. Whereas for my job, it's a little bit crazy because there's no structure in a way. So I'm always quite nervous on fight night because fight night is where
Yeah.
you majority of views, where you make the majority of your income of AdSense, pay the flights back and hotels back. So I pay for everything myself. And
Wow.
yeah. Well, a lot of
You
people
hustling, but
this.
you
A
caught
lot of
Logan
people.
Paul though. You got Logan Paul, right? You caught Logan Paul and Mike. That was a bigger
Yeah,
name.
that was gold. That do you see the interview? It's hilarious.
Yeah, bro. So fun. You didn't even realize what they were doing when they turned your back on you. You're so innocent, bro. They both turned to you like this. You didn't even know what's going on. You're still continuing the interview. I was dying, bro. Like
You
in
gotta
your face when you look.
keep working
Yeah,
for anything.
you stopped for a second. You got so confused, bro. You just looked at them, and then you still continued interviewing. Yo, it's so funny, bro. Your eyes when you're looking at Mike, you're like so innocent, bro. And they're huge. They're so big compared to you, bro.
Mike's quite
Yo,
big as well. Logan's big, but Mike's taller as well.
Mike is big. And Logan's big too. That picture is so funny, bro. That's like the funniest picture I've seen in a long, long time. I love that
What's
picture.
better, that photo or the photo of me bringing out the fight?
Oh man, they're both gold, bro. Those gotta be in the Hall of Fame of Fred, bro. Like if Fred, the Fred Hall of Fame, those two pictures gotta be there, bro, for real.
My
I
funeral. At my funeral, you have
see.
those two pictures up there. When
Oh man,
I
yo,
get
Fred, you're
killed in
killing
this
it.
ring
You're killing
fight.
it, yo, Fred. I gotta say, you're killing it right now, bro. You are literally killing the game right now, Fred. I gotta give you a round of applause for everything. You've been hustling so hard. For someone that's 18 and you're hustling this hard, I respect it, bro. You're gonna go very far in life with this kind of like mentality and a hustle mindset, bro. So, Wed, I say Red, wait, W Fred, let's go.
Oh yes, sir. That does mean a lot. I guess the reason why I sound kind of cocky, maybe, but the reason why I work so hard is I'm so worried. I don't want to work a normal job. I'm so scared of like working a normal job. Okay, well, yeah, this is quite hard. To be fair, working doing YouTube, it seems quite easy, but like doing an interview, I always say is like actually me talking to you right now is the easy part. It's about 10% of the interview, whereas the other 90% is making sure the lighting's good, the equipment's working, the camera's recording, making sure you talk
Yeah.
the right points at the right time. Make sure you got them at the right time. Saying, "Oh yeah, mate, come over here for an interview, quick." So there's a lot more to it than people think, I think. But I'm just so scared
Yeah.
of a normal job. That's rude. I want to be someone. I just want to be someone. Do you know what I mean? That's what I mean. Normal. I don't want to be a normal person, everyday person.
Yeah. I
Yeah.
feel you, bro. I feel you, man. But yo, with that hustle mindset, you're gonna get very far, bro. I believe it. Like, you know what I mean? I can see you going like further into the boxing scene, which is dope. But yeah, YouTube is not, it's not easy. People think it's easy. It's very hard. Like, you gotta be dedicated, you gotta be grinding, you gotta be on your stuff every single day, you know, the cameras charged, all that. It's, bro, it's a headache, bro. People don't really understand. But you know what is you doing? You're doing good, bro. You're placing yourself at the right places at the right time. And you're going to all these events and doing all these interviews. But I have a question. Have you ever had like an awkward interview? Like you try to interview someone and they just have like whack answers or something?
Well, I think nowadays, if I was interviewing a YouTuber and it got really awkward, it would be perfect because people would react to it and it would go quite viral. But back when I first started, I interviewed a boxer called Tyron McKenna. And I never even put this interview out. So I think my 10th or 11th interview. And I asked her a question about, oh, would you want to fight a boxer called Carl Frampton? And Carl Frampton, I didn't realize at the time, when it was like three weight classes below him. It's like, no, why'd I fight him? He's like three weight classes below me. And then Zoom started lagging and got really, really awkward. And I was like, is there anything else you want me to ask you? And he's like, not really, Fred. I was like, okay. So that's probably the most awkward interview I've ever had. So yeah, it was a bit like, oh, sugar. But now,
That's
the
funny.
way I'm right talking to you right now is how I'm in real life. So it's not really awkward. And I kind of got to a
Yeah.
scene where most people in like the YouTube scene, because the YouTube scene is actually a very small scene. I used to think from the outside looking in, oh, it's massive. It's loads and loads of creators. But now looking at, now you can side it, everyone knows who everyone is. So if you get a bad name, everyone kind of knows he's got a bad name. So you do want to keep a good name. I'm just kind of saying, I'm just nice to everyone. I never like suck up to a certain person. How I talk to you right now is how I talk to someone who a cameraman or someone who's not necessarily a YouTuber or someone who's or how do you phrase it? Someone who's maybe not like making as much money as someone else. I think like you've got to treat everyone the exact same amount of respect. And I think
I like that. I like
that's
that
why
a
I maybe
lot,
come
bro.
across quite better because I talked to, let's say, if the toilet cleaner, which is not seen as good as a YouTuber. You talk to the toilet cleaner as you talk to someone who's very, very successful, as you talk to Logan Paul. So you don't like try and suck up to someone. You just talk to everyone the exact same. I think that's why maybe I've got a good relationship with most people, with everyone actually. Maybe not Dylan Dennis, but with everyone else, good relationship.
Yeah, man. I like that you said that, bro. Because a lot of people, I had a conversation with one of my managers, and I was telling him, I was like, yo, bro, a lot of people they would treat you differently if you had they had nothing to gain from you. You get me? So if they see you, if they see you as someone like, oh, he's a nobody, like I have nothing to gain from him, from being friends with him or being nice to him. So they'll treat you like shit. Or rather than if they see someone else who's like a name, they'll treat them like, you know, like gold because they know there's everything to gain from them. You get me? So like you gotta treat, I see it as like I don't care who you are, you gotta treat everybody good, bro. Everybody right. But speaking of Dylan Dennis, I don't know what happened. What happened with you and Dylan Dennis?
Well, I actually kind of saved his, not saved his life, but I saved him from getting hurt by Anthony Taylor properly because even though it sounds kind of cocky, because Anthony Taylor swung the overhand. I think I might have held his other arm because Andy Taylor, you never just swing an overhand right. You're going to follow up, aren't you, with a left hook and then a backhand. I was kind of in the way of him. So if I wasn't there, Andy Taylor would probably use a combination, probably bash him a little bit more. So I kind of helped him out a little bit there. And then
Yo,
after.
that punch came out of nowhere. That punch came out of nowhere. Like,
Yeah.
I thought, you know what? When I watched the clip, I thought like Dylan Dennis did something to Anthony for him to for that to happen. But
No.
there was literally no reason. Like, there was he did it for no. That's the funny part about the whole thing, bro. Like, he literally did it for no reason, bro. Like, I swear, I thought he talked about his mom. Or he's like, bro, he just ran up to him, punched him, and he got love for it, bro. Yo, you know what can you say, bro? Because Dylan Dennis is that hated, bro. He's just that hated. If you Bro, if a tree falls down on Dylan Dennis, people will like applaud and be happy about it. I mean, that's how much of a hated man he is, which is crazy. Like I think he plays a great villain role, and that's why it's
Yeah, he
good for KSI
does.
to fight him. Him and KSI fighting is very good for KSI because KSI gets leaning towards that hero side, and he's like the villain, and KSI beating the villain to make up take him to a whole different level too.
It's like WWE, kind of the baby face versus the heel, or the face versus the heel. But then it's after he's face up in the ring of KSI. And I think, to be fair, on Dillian's side, I don't have anything against it, and I think he was nice to me before he slapped my phone in my hand. Yeah, what was it? I think he was quite drunk, so I remember him seeing him kind of stumble around like on footage after, like the next day or next 2 days after on social media, after the face off of KSI. I think he might stumble down and fell on a chair and try to swing at KSI. And then anyway, he came, I didn't know any of this. I came back into the room, like in the corridor. And obviously, my job is to film people, so ask me questions. I was like, Dylan, are you okay, mate? Or something like that. And so I filmed him, and he's brother his slaps the phone in my hand. So blimey. It's a bit, I think it's a little bit off, don't you think?
He literally just slapped your phone. I seen the 30-second clip. I just seen him walk up to you and you're like, "What's up, Dylan?" And he just slapped your phone. It's just funny to me, bro. Like it's not like, why do you do that? I have no idea. Like
He's a heel.
I
He's
really
just
don't
playing.
know.
He's basically playing a character, but there's nothing gained from me slapping my phone in my hand. I mean, if it was my camera, like this, slap the phone like this down my hand, I'd be like, sugar. But that's really, really expensive. I guess the phone is too, but I don't think it's really biggest deal. But it's still a bit annoying at the same time because now I've got it might be a bit awkward me interviewing him soon in January. I'll ask him straight. I'm like, Dylan, nice to see you again, mate. Why'd you slap the phone in my hand? I'll say something like that.
That's funny as hell, bro. You'll meet in January though, right? In London?
I'll be everywhere. Definitely January.
Bro, this event was supposed to be in Houston, Texas, but now since Logan Paul's not fighting, they pushed it to London, the Wembley Arena. And I can't complain fighting in the Wembley Arena. That'd be amazing. How much seaters does that hold? Like,
Wembley Arena was where Deji fought Alistair Sarby. It was a showstar event.
really?
Yeah, the same arena.
That's Wembley Arena?
Yeah. I'm
I
not
thought it was
sure. I'm not...
O2.
No, that wasn't. Wembley Arena, I'm not sure honestly. I think I'll look it up for you right now, Wembley Arena capacity. 12,500 people. That's quite a lot. That was
Wow.
being loud in there as well. That 100% sell out.
Yeah, definitely. I think definitely
The
sell out
O2
Wembley
sold
Arena.
out. Wembley Arena, less people is definitely going to sell out.
What's the more notorious arena? O2 or Wembley?
The O2's like 20,000.
Oh.
I'm not sure why. I asked Mam today. I'm interviewing Mam today. I asked why we didn't choose the O2 arena. Maybe it was booked up or something.
Yeah, maybe or it's just like more it's more expensive and stuff and I don't know. Maybe I have no idea, honestly. I really don't know. If Logan
We
Paul's on
did,
the card, it would, huh?
yeah. But I think it's better in the UK. UK, the crossover boxing and influencer boxing scene is a lot bigger than it is in the UK. Because I just remember crossover boxing, and my fan or my kind of supporters, subscribers, that most of them are from the UK.
Definitely. Same. I agree. Because even when I'm in the UK, bro, like, I get mad. Like, I get spotted everywhere and stuff. Like, but UK is different, bro. Like, the love I get in UK is unbelievable. Like, it's unbelievable love. So, like, I need to pop out to the UK more, bro. They show a lot of love out there, bro. Honestly. Like they love crossover boxing.
I always find it funny how you kind of hated kind of the heel move. Like all the comments in the old YouTube videos, like, oh, I hate Slim, that sort of thing. Now it's all love. There's literally no hate whatsoever. It's all love.
Yeah. Insane, right? Like, bro, you were still nice to me even though when people hated me. I'll never forget that, Fred. I will never. You were nice to me when people hated me, bro. You were interviewing me and everything. Remember at Kingpin? I was getting violated, bro. I was talking my shit. Oh my God. Wow. It's crazy how times have changed just in a few months, right?
Yeah, life changes. Like, I mean, if you're consistent working hard, well, not even a year, if you're consistent working hard for 3 months, something will change, something big will change. Then 6 months, 9 months, 12 months. I mean, back in March, I was on 2,000 subs, and now I'm on 55,000. That's crazy. It's like a
Yeah,
massive,
bro.
isn't it? So that's, if you work hard at something, stuff just changes. But you're on this card. Who've you got? I know Mams, I know Mams said this, he called me up earlier and he was doing a few of the matchmaking stuff. I was talking about him about the interview. We're gonna do it later. Who do you think you're gonna fight? Who do you reckon? Who are the options?
Who am I gonna fight? I can't say, but I already got a fight locked in, and
Oh,
it's gonna
it's
be a,
done. It's confirmed.
yeah, it's pretty much confirmed. It's like verbally agreed. We're gonna make it happen. It's gonna be a little not people are gonna expect this one, honestly. It's not gonna expect it, but it's gonna be a good one, I think. It's gonna be a really good one.
When will it be announced?
I have no idea, bro. I have no idea. I'm gonna post like an Instagram post today, just like hyping up a little bit, but it's gonna be announced very soon. Your boy Slim, the Hitman, back in action. You like watching me fight, right?
Who doesn't?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, bro. So
That's
I'm
perfect.
excited,
That's
bro.
perfect, Slim. I'll get you on for another interview when the fight's announced. Are you going up
Hey,
class, down a weight class, staying the same weight class?
Bro, I'm bro. The weight class I'm fighting at right now, the last two fights, are a weight class way above my natural, like,
And what is
fucking.
that?
Bro, I've been fighting. I'm trying to. I can't even make 175. I'm fighting at 175. I'm not even making it. I was 169 last fight. The other fight was 171. Like, I'm nowhere near 175. I'm like 4 pounds. I can't make it, bro. It's so big for me, bro. It's like you, Fred. How much you weigh?
I'm 62 kgs. That's 135 pounds.
135 pounds. That's what you fight at, right?
Yeah.
So you fight at 135. Imagine you going up to 154, bro, and fighting 154. Imagine fighting over there and trying to maintain 154. Like the most you could probably reach is like 145, 140, wait, or 146 or something. That's what you're stuffing yourself. Imagine, and you're fighting these dudes that are coming down to 154, like bigger guys. That's what I'm doing, bro. I'm fighting these big ass dudes that are coming down in weight, and I'm still knocking them out, bro. Come on. Where's my props at? Like, look at Temper. He fought at 189 pounds last fight. 189. I fought him at 175, bro. So imagine he starved himself to go down to 175, and then he shot back up in weight. And then Ryan Taylor, he fought at 190, bro. He fought at 190 against Anthony Taylor, and then he went down to 178. I was 169. Shot back up to 190 easily, like with the water hydration. You know about hydration, right?
Yeah.
It's easy. It's so easy when you're naturally that weight. So he shoots back up. And then that's why it's just harder for me. It's way harder for me. I'm fighting these way bigger guys, bro. But you know what? I still got the skill to deal with them, you know?
Still got the power. But for your fight that's going to be announced soon, what weight will that be?
Thinking the same thing, but it's another naturally bigger guy coming
Oh, so
down. Like,
you're still fighting in the same weight class you fought your last two fights at.
yeah, that's where I got the belt at. I got the belt at 175, bro. That's not even this weight, bro. This is not me.
What a bad problem to have, Slim.
Yeah, man. Like, shit, bro. But you know what? It's all good, bro, because I can
Has this?
handle it, right, Fred?
Hell yeah, but has this person fought in infinite spot scene before? They have. Okay, that's okay. I can't really.
Something like that. Something like that.
Fine, okay. Well, if
Definitely.
something
And
like that,
this person has experience fighting. This person did like combat sports before, you know what I mean? So this is gonna be a good fight. It's gonna be a good fight. Tough competitor,
so have they fought on like
crazy
an
guy.
influencer? Have they fought on an influencer card before?
Yes, they did.
Okay. All right. I'm going to push a big pop. I'll post this clip on Twitter and everyone's gonna be like commenting underneath. Who is it? Who is it? Who is it? There are loads of names. But
Oh, well, I'll say, I mean, yeah, I don't want to say too much because
yeah.
if I say this piece of information, you guys are probably gonna know who it is. But it's gonna be an interesting one. This person's kind of psychotic, bro. I ain't gonna lie. So it's gonna be a
Will
good
the
one.
trash talk be good in the build up?
Oh my God, that's why it's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be a build up for this fight's gonna be insane. It's gonna be a crazy build-up.
That's good. That means there's lots of interviews then.
That means this person has a wild personality. That's all I gotta say.
That's what
Wild
you want.
personality.
That's what you want already, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I guess so, but at the same time, I want a good fight. That's what I want. And I think he's gonna come and give a good fight. I think it's a good test for me. It's a good test for me. To see where I'm at as a fighter. And I'm here for it, man. I'm here to grow. I want to keep growing as a fighter because I'm still new to the sport, Fred. Like, Fred, how long have you been boxing for? You've been boxing for a while, right?
No comment.
You know, comment. I know you've been boxing for a while. Me, Fred, bro. I just started, bro. I just started, like, you know what I mean? So, like, I'm learning through every fight. People learn through amateur experience. I'm not learning through amateur experience. I'm learning through pro fights. Like, I'm learning everything. Like, the last fight with Ryan Taylor, I learned so much about myself as a fighter. And one of my boys told me, who's a pro fighter, he's like, yo, for you to find yourself as a fighter, you need 45 to 50 fights. That's how you actually really find yourself as a fighter. Like, that's when you really begin to find yourself. I'm like, damn, I had only five fights, bro. I'm way, like, I'm not even at my maximum potential yet, Fred. I am nowhere near my maximum potential.
That's why it's so exciting. I find it quite interesting watching these cards now, all the way back to about four cards ago. Because everyone now, well, the main part is they're quite skilled. It's
Yeah.
they're not swinging their chin up in the air, kind of novice fighters anymore. They're actually kind of like they're kind of the amateur level now, still kind of skilled. So it's quite good to watch now because it's a bit more the levels just gonna go up and up and up and up and up. So soon, you're
Definitely.
an influencer and you want to start boxing, better start training now because levels can go higher and higher and higher. There's soon there'll be a time where like someone's too experienced in the same weight class, same level of clout, but someone's too experienced. So I guess if you're an influencer YouTuber, better start training. But your coach, he followed me on Instagram. He gets a lot of respect. Anytime you bring his name up, he gets a ton of respect, doesn't he?
Saddam, he follow me on
Yeah.
Instagram? That's what's up. He's a goat. I love Saddam. Saddam is a very respected fighter, bro. I don't know if you know about him, bro. He's legit, man. He's so legit.
He fought Miguel Cotto.
He beat Miguel Cotto too as an underdog, bro, in Madison Square Garden. You know what I mean? And not only that, like he made the 2008 Olympics. You know, he has a very high level amateur background. Like everybody in the boxing scene respects him because, like, bro, he's a very good fighter, bro, very good fighter. And I imagine I'm alongside that dude. So you know, I have someone like that on my side to help me up my game every single day. You know, so I'm privileged for that.
Exactly. I want to go on the pads of him. Next time you're in London, I'll go on the pads of him.
Hey, bet. Say no more. We're gonna be in London very soon for the Wembley Arena, baby. I can't
Will
wait,
there
man.
be any? Will you be coming to London to do any press or anything like that? Any press tours or before January?
Nah, bro. I'm gonna stay working. I'm gonna stay in camp mode right now. You know, stay busy. I've been traveling a lot recently, so like I just want to stay working, stay motivated, stay focused until January. I want to be coming out looking like the Hulk when you see me, bro. I want to look like the motherfucking Hulk when you see me, Fred. You know what I mean? I'm trying to bulk up. I need to bulk up at least a little bit. It's so hard for me, though. I'm too skinny, bro. This is my natural body, bro. It's hard to bulk up a little bit, man. But I'm gonna see what I
Do you
can
have a
do.
high metabolism? Can't say the word. Do you have a high
I'm
metabolism?
a fast metabolism, yeah.
Yeah.
Fast metabolism, yes, I do, bro. Every time I eat, I take a shake. I take a
Yeah,
nice little sh Every time I eat, I take a nice little fat shite. You know what I'm saying, Mike? Is that Justin Bieber merch right there? I see you.
look at that. You know who got it for me?
Who?
You can't, they're impossible to get, especially in the UK. The red Justin Bieber merch, you can't get it anywhere. But
Who got it?
Kristen Hamby got it for me.
Wow.
What a
That
legend.
dude is. Yeah. He don't want to fight me, though.
Oh, really?
He used to talk so much shit about me, but he don't want to fight me. He used to talk mad shit, but he don't want to fight me.
Well,
He don't want to fight me.
he just got me Justin Bieber hoodie, so I got nothing against
Well,
Kristen.
tell him to fight me. Tell him to fight me, Fred. Tell him to fight me.
I'll bring it up next time I see you.
Tell your boy to fight me, man.
I think he's fighting someone else, Kristen Hamby.
Yeah, because he don't want to fight me. He been talking mad shit, but he don't want to fight me. Talking all that shit, but he don't want to fight me.
Who else do you not like in the influencer boxing world? Who else do you have like a distaste for? Just surely
Man,
talk bad about you. Like it's trash.
a lot of people used to talk bad about me, but now it's crazy. They all respect me now. They all respect me. So it's like I'm cool with everybody, bro. But like, man, before all that, like you know, I was trying to fight Christian Hamby. I was trying to fight that dude Jack. Like, oh, like Christian Hamby's a little crew. I was trying to fight. You know, the Ryan Taylor. That's but I already beat Ryan Taylor. So like, he was like the biggest one out of all of them, I guess. Would you say he was the best one out of all of them? Like, he's probably the
Who?
toughest one, definitely. Ryan
Who?
Taylor.
I think
Ryan
Ryan
Taylor
is
was
the
a.
better. Probably he's probably more skilled than Chris Hamby right now.
More skilled and more tougher and more bigger, stronger. You know what I mean? So I think he's all like all that on them. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. I mean, I right as of right now, I really don't dislike nobody because I'm in a good position. Before I used to dislike a lot of people. Like I used to dislike Kenny. Me and Kenny used to go at it. Me and Temper used to go at it. But I already got through Temper. Kenny
What do you
used to
make of that?
say
On
that.
Twitter, they've all been arguing, haven't they?
Oh, Kenny and Temper arguing that shit was hilarious, bro. So funny, bro. And they keep bringing me up though. Like Temper, like every time he has an accomplishment, they keep bringing up Slim. Like my name is tied to him. That's why Temper wants that rematch because like I tainted his legacy. You get me? So like every time he gets like he talks shit, like he will bring up Slim, Slim, Slim. Like Nico, the whole Beta Squad was showing like calling him my son and stuff. I'm like, damn, I could tell that he hates that. You know, I could tell. And but he beat Kenny. He actually beat Kenny convincingly, like easily. He beat Kenny easily. Like you know what I mean? And we got to see that rematch. So they're both talking trash to each other. They both got first round knockouts. Why not, right? I think that's a good matchup. They got to make that happen in 2023, I think.
Who do you think wins the rematch? Because Ken is very good now.
Yeah, you know, Kenny got much better. He definitely got much better. Like, he surprised me in the last fight, honestly. Like, I didn't think he was going to beat DK Money that easily. I thought DK Money was going to give him some trouble, but he smoked him. He smoked him. And what else? To win the rematch? Man, I don't know. I'm still leaning towards Temper for the win against Kenny.
Oh,
Honestly,
really?
I still lean towards Temper. I think Kenny will do much better though. I think he'll do much better, but I think Temper is just, man. I think he just fights too good against someone like Kenny. You know?
I wish that fight could be 6 rounds because you see much, so much more than 4 rounds.
They fought 5 rounds last time.
Was it 5 rounds?
They fought 5 rounds, Kenny and
Oh, wow, I
Temper.
didn't know
Yeah, it was a 5 round fight. 5 2 minutes though.
that. Hopefully, now it can be 6. I'll ask Mam 6 2 minutes because it seems like such good fights that they're good at distance. Well, none of them really went the distance last time, but
Yeah,
when they
that's what
get
I'm saying.
on 4 rounds, 3 minutes, it's only 12 minutes. It's
But
long.
But at the end of the day, you know, when people do pro fights, professional boxing, when they go pro, they start off with 3 rounds, then they go to 4 rounds, then they go to 6 rounds, then they go to 8 rounds. Like, you don't start off going to four. Like, I think long down the line, we're gonna start doing like 6 round fights, 8 round fights. But that's like to the more experienced fighters. You know what I mean? People who have been in the scene longer. So like, and the newbies are gonna continue doing 3, 4 round fights. So like, I think that, you know, with time, the scene's gonna keep growing. It's like only 3 events. It's been massive already. 3 events. Been crazy, and
The
I feel like
last one is very,
2023
very good as well. The last one is extremely good.
amazing card with no main head, with no headline fight. Like, the only best, like, Haseem Ahmed, he was like the biggest headline over there, big headline fighter. Dean the Great, like, he's still young. It was his second fight, bro. Like, you know, like, there was not much big names, like massive names. You're talking about like a KSI or like a Logan Paul, but they still like did amazing,
But
right?
do you know Waleed Sharps was that good?
I knew he was good. I knew he was good,
Do you
but
expect
I
him
didn't
to
think he
lose
was
a
gonna.
fight like that?
Say it again,
Do you expect him to fight that good against Dean?
bro. I didn't think he was gonna drop Dean that many times, bro. Like, when he was actually like beating Dean that bad, I was actually surprised. But yo, Dean did his thing, bro. He did his thing, honestly. Like, he came back, bro. To begin to losing a be losing a fight like that, like, it does you mentally in a fight. Like, shit, can I actually win? Can I win? But yo, he kept coming forward. Third round, like, it took him 3 rounds. And he landed it. That's it. Like, you gotta respect that. Like, Dean did his thing, yo. Like, a lot of people will be mentally like, shit, I'm losing. I can't win this fight at this point. But he still had that championship mentality, and he knocked him out, bro. You know? What do you think of the stoppage, though? Do you like the stoppage?
Well, I didn't really. I was watching it live. I stopped loading the Logan Paul interview, and I was kind of seeing on the screen, and looking back down at my computer. I have watched it back. It's difficult. It's because I interviewed him after the fight. I got Waleed's point of view. So on Twitter, when they were tweeting that you can't really, it's good, but you can't really understand what they're saying. They're not giving much perspective. But when I sat down and interviewed him, I could see where he was coming from. But I can also see where Dean was coming from as well. But I think it's, if it did carry on, wouldn't Dean have just stopped him, just hit him a few more punches, and they got stopped as well? That's the only thing that I'm
Yeah,
thinking about. So
that's
would he
it.
have hurt more? That's the only thing I'm expecting on it.
It could have went two ways. Either Waleed could have recovered, or I think Dean would have finished. But I honestly think he was done, bro. Like, he was out of it.
How
But the
long was left in
referee,
the round?
it was 1:30 left in the round.
Okay, so still a while. So I guess Willie could have clinched a bit. It'd be interesting. Maybe it could have gone on, but it's just a bit like
That's the thing.
he
That's
said.
that. That's what makes it so controversial. That's what makes it so controversial, bro. The fact that he could have continued and stuff. So like, if he could have, like, the ref should have let him continue, honestly. Like, at least ask him, like, yo, are you can you continue? Can you con He didn't ask him that. He just waved it off. But he turned his back on the ref and he leaned against the ropes. That was the biggest mistake he ever did, bro. You know what I mean? But we'll never know. Dean is congratulations to Dean. He did his thing.
Yeah, 100%. Dean's a man in that weight class now, but they'll rematch. Not yet, but they'll rematch in a few fights down the line. Do you see Dean coming out, or will he come out on top of that rematch?
Yo, boxing, you never know, man. I think Waleed's like, he's honestly, I don't know who wins the rematch. You never know, bro. You never know. Maybe Dean could adjust, like, you know, like, down the line. These guys are both young fighters, so they still like grow and learn and get better with time. So like, but I think that by the time the rematch happens, it's gonna be a while, you know. So like,
Yeah.
I think Waleed still needs to work his way back up, because Dean's on top of the game right now.
Who do you think wins, Dean or Jose Aldo Jr.?
I haven't seen Jose Aljo Jr. box, but he's no joke though. He's
He's
a
good.
great
I saw him
striker.
sparring,
He's been
Mikey Garcia clip on YouTube.
Yeah?
He's very, very good, Jose Aldo, at boxing as well.
Oh my God. No way.
That fight should happen, but it should be like a 6 or 8 round fight, not a 4 round fight.
That's actually crazy, bro. That'd be crazy to fight Jose Aldo Jr. That'd be insane.
That would be insane. But you've got eight. We've been going for quite a while here. I know you've got training in a minute. Are you sparring today?
I just got out to the gym yesterday. I did my session yesterday. I'm gonna start sparring probably end of this week or some shit, or next week. I'm gonna see what's up. I just got back to training, so get my fitness back to where it's at. Do my runs, do all that shit. Get back at it, man. And by the time next time you see me, Fred, I'm gonna look like Superman, or like Anthony Joshua, or like Anthony Joshua.
The Middle Eastern version of Andy Joshua.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Awesome, Slim. I'll put all your socials in the description, but I'll see you very, very soon. Very not actually, yeah, I'll see you really soon. Actually, it's near the end of November now. We've got a whole month
Yeah.
of December. Will be quite hard doing content for. There's no event, but I'll get through it. And then January will be a blast.
Yes, sir. That's what I'm talking about, Fred, my boy, bro. Appreciate you having me on here, like always, man. Love you, bro. My mans.